In this video, you will learn how we can use local binding patterns for the face recognition. As you can see here, we already use local binding patterns for the different projects. Now we will try to understand how we can use local binding patterns for the face recognition. Certain requirements, as you can see here, we need a well-maintained personal computer or laptop, digital images for the testing and training purpose, and you can use any software tool for the implementation. Right now you can see here, we divided the digital images into two data sets, one for the training images, another for the testing images. And you can see here, we created the two folders, one for training images, another for testing images. In the training images folder, we will place all the images, and in the testing image folder, we will place the image that we are looking for identification. Now the face recognition and the face identification is one-to-many matching process. So what we will do, we will match the test image that is present in the testing dataset with all the images that are present in the training dataset. So here we will match the digital images that are present in the testing folder with all the images that are present in the training dataset. If an image found, it means image is identified, else not. This is the basic operation that we are following here for all the digital images that are present in the testing and the training dataset. So for each digital image, we will perform first image pre-processing. Here we can resize image and image conversion and other. After that, we will extract the local binary patterns for each digital image, and we will save the LBP values for further use. And then we will construct the histogram for each digital image in the testing and training folder. You know how histogram is constructed. Digital image is divided into different blocks, and for each block we will construct the histogram. Here you can see this is the final output, that is the, here we use the histogram concatenation. You can see the values here. After that, we will calculate the Euclidean difference, or you can say Euclidean distance. If Euclidean distance is 0, it means match found, it means image is identified in the training dataset, else not. So here our aim is to generate the matching score for each digital image during testing and training. Now you can see here we have first case. Suppose this is the training dataset, and in the training dataset, suppose we have 4 images, and here we have suppose testing dataset, and this is the query image that we are searching in the dataset. Now as we human can easily see, this image is present here. Now our task is here how computer will decide whether this image is present in the training dataset or not. Now we will try to perform certain actions so that computer can identify this image in the training dataset. So we will calculate the similarity score for each image. Now how we can calculate the similarity score? We will calculate the LBP values for each digital image, and after that we will calculate the Euclidean distance, and if Euclidean distance is 0, it means match found, else not. Here you can see for the training dataset we have 4 digital images, and you can see the LBP values that we calculated for each digital image. We calculated all these values after all the operations like image preprocessing, feature extraction, histogram construction, and then we have LBP values done. You can check all these values in the workspace. Now you can see for the testing dataset we have LBP value for this image, you can see here. And now we will calculate the Euclidean distance. Here you can see value is 0 here. You can easily see that this value is matched here. Done. And Euclidean distance for the first one we got is 0. So if the Euclidean distance is 0, it means match found, face is identified. Now computer will find out the location, or you can see the position for the found match. And you can see it is present at the first position. So here we got the 100% identification rate. Why 100%? Because we are looking for just one image and it is found in the dataset. That's why it is 100%. Now case 2, you can see here we have 6 images in the training dataset, and now we are looking for this image. This time again, you can see first we will calculate the LBP values. You can see the LBP values for all the images that are present in the training dataset, and here you can see the LBP value for this one, and you can see this value is matched with the fifth image, this one. Got it. Now we will calculate the Euclidean distance, because if Euclidean distance between two images is zero, it means match found, image is identified. Now you can see match is found here at location 5. Done. Now you can see here third case. Now this time you can see here we have in the training dataset 5 images, in the testing dataset just 1 image, and this time you can see all these images are different in the training and testing dataset. Now you can see this person, as we human can see that this is the same person present in the training and testing dataset. But now our task is how computer will decide whether this is the same human, whether not. As in this case, using Euclidean distance, computer can identify that this is the similar image and it is identified. Now how, in this case, how computer will decide that this is the same person with different facial expressions present in the training dataset? So again, we will calculate the LBP values for both training dataset and testing dataset, as you can see here, and you can see no values matched here. Now we will calculate the Euclidean distance, and you can see once we calculated the Euclidean distance, so right now you can see here in the Euclidean distance we got the maximum value for this image, and this is not the person that we are looking for, and we also got the maximum value. So now we can consider here, we can do some modification. So you can do certain modification in the code. We will select the one with the minimum value. Here you can see for all these value we got the minimum, and for the first image we got the minimum among all. So we can consider this as the match for the testing image, or you can see the query image. So here we need to do some modification in the code so that we can prove that this is the same person that computer identified. So this time we will select the minimum value among all. Now let's try this for another case. This time you can see in the training dataset we have 4 different images. Here you can see we have 4 same images and 1 different. Right now we have totally different persons in the training dataset, and now we are looking for this one. Now how we can identify this? And you can see here the facial expressions for these 2 images are different. So if you will try to calculate the Euclidean distance, and then it is not 0. So now again, how computer will decide whether this is the same person with different facial expressions? So again, calculate. You can see the LBP values we computed for the training dataset and for the testing dataset. You can see no matches found here, and we calculated the distance, and you can see for the 4th image we got the minimum value. And you can see for all these images we got maximum values, and only just for this image we got the minimum value. So we can consider the minimum value as a match, as computer cannot decide whether this is the same one or not. So using this value we can modify the code, and we can show that this is the same person. So that's all about this video. If you have any question, you can comment below, and thanks for watching this video.